Let me know what you need me to do today.
Okay.
Praise the Lord, all in the chemistry. Thank you.
Thank you. most holy and most gracious Father. We thank you, Father, for all that is to come. We thank you for the day, minute by minute. Father, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. We come to you as humble as we know how. Praising you.
And it not fear.
Amen.
Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in the pavilion and the secret of the tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock. And now shall my head be lifted up above my enemies round about me.
Amen.
Therefore will I offer in the tabernacle of sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice. Have mercy also upon me, and answer me. When thou saidest, seek ye my face. My heart said unto thee, thy face, Lord, will I seek. Hide not thy face far from me. Put not thy servant away in anger. Thou hast been my help. Leave me not, neither forsake me, O God of my salvation. When my father and my mother forsake me, then the Lord will take me up. Teach me thy way, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of my enemies. Deliver me not over unto the will of my enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breed out cruelty. I have fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
Yes.
And verse 14, wait on the Lord. Be of good courage.
Yes.
And he shall strengthen thy heart.
Yes.
Wait, I say, on the Lord.
Wait
on the Lord. Thank God for reading his word.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, God.
Thank you.
Yeah.
you said you are alive and well. You said you are our shepherd, and we are the people and the sheep of God's pasture.
Yeah.
You are shepherd. You say your sheep hear your voice. Mm-hmm. And you say you know your sheep, and we will not follow a stranger. But we will follow only you, Lord. Please come on. Help our children and turn from our evil ways, Lord. And come only unto you, Lord, seeking your favor. That you will heal our land, you will heal our people, you will forgive us of all of our sins that we committed against you. Father, something you said. You said you knew we were sinners, but you told us to repent.
Yes.
And repent and be real, be honest, be genuine, be true. Even if it won't come to God and be true with you, because you will forgive us, you will give us life, you will give us,
yes.
You save us, you provide for us.
Yes.
God, we give you the glory, not man. God, we look into you for divine salvation. We look into you for divine Father,
Come on, put your hands together and give God a hand clap of praise, amen. I want you to know that the Holy Ghost is in this place. And I know that we got to do a few things, but I believe that it's right now preaching time. So I'm going to ask that the praise team will sing us a psalmic hymn or a selection, and then the next one she will hear will be God at this moment. Amen.
Oh. That same snake bit her
and injected her with her deadly venom. On her deathbed, the woman asked the snake, after all I did for you, why did you bite me? The snake replied, you knew I was a snake when you picked me up. Has anyone in the room was just like this woman who ever provided assistance to a snake? You don't have to respond, but I know you're in church, but you have everybody in this room ever been in love with a snake or spend too many days or years of your life with a snake? Has anyone in the room ever provided room, clothing, or even fed a snake before? My brothers and sisters, I've learned that a snake is a snake, whether it's a garden snake, or a rattlesnake, a copperhead snake, or a harmless black snake. In my opinion, a snake is a snake. And just because a snake is not moving doesn't mean that the snake is dead. What I have learned pastoring black folks for mostly 10 years of my life, a quiet snake is the worst snake of them all. A quiet snake is like those people who throw rocks at you and then hide their very hand. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but there are some people wondering why you stop talking to them and why you don't fool with them anymore. And you don't because one day you discover that they were. I think I got a church here this morning. And what you need to know is this, even when a snake sheds its skin, it's still a snake. Even when a snake puts it on its uniform, it's still a snake. Even when that snake is smiling and grinning in your face, that snake is still a snake. I don't like snakes. Snakes are creepy and snakes are sneaky. Some of you may remember that movie years ago that featured Samuel Jackson. It was entitled Snakes on the Plane. Y'all remember that movie, so I don't have to spoil it. That was a crazy movie. But if you remember the movie, you know that when the plane was at the terminal, the snakes were silent and still. When the plane was on the runway, the snakes were silent and still. But if you remember the movie, the snakes really didn't start hissing and causing havoc until the plane was in midair. Can I tell you, beloved, that sometimes snakes don't reveal themselves until after you take off. Please, Dr. Gilbert. They don't reveal themselves until you have assisted them in reaching another elevation. They were cool when you were on their level, but now that you are hot and fly and high, now they're talking about how you have changed and how you are no longer a people or person anymore. It's not that I'm no longer a people's person. I'm just not a stupid people person anymore. And church, I don't know if you ever experienced this before, but there is no hurt like the hurt that comes after you have been hurt by somebody that you love. Somebody that you trusted, somebody that you respected. There was no hurt like the hurt that comes after someone gave you your heart to a peace of mind to. Somebody you thought of that somebody you told your secrets to, somebody you have leaned on. You don't know hurt until one day you discover that the person who you once thought was everything turned out to be nothing at all, or just what everybody else tried to tell you they were in the first place. But you were just too naive, and you were just too spiritual, and you just kept praying and praying and praying, and you became too spiritual. sympathetic, too sorry, and too much of a saint to understand that some people will never change. Do I have a church here? I read something recently, Reverend Davis, that says some people never change. They just become more of who they truly are. I preach Dr. Kendrick. And one fact of this life is this. You have your share of friends, but just as there are friends, there will be some enemies. Yes, there will be some enemy, but you can't talk about your enemies without first thanking God for your friends. Can you thank God for your friends today? Come on and thank God for the people who pray for you, the people who walk with you, the people who hold your hand and call you just to make sure that you are okay. Friends who won't need you hanging. Can I learn you something, beloved? Real friends are not just there for the fun time, but they will be with you when life is not being fair at you. And I'm learning that there's not all of your friends will be your complexion. Come on and talk back to me in here, because I remember that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who once had a dream that his four little children would one day live in a nation where they did not be judged by the color of their skin, but the of their character. Thank God for your colored friends. Thank God for your black friends. Thank God for your Negro friend that you have. But you also gotta thank God for your friends who don't look like you. Thank God for your white friend. Thank God for your Hispanic friend. Just thank God, because my brothers and sisters, God so world that it came his only begotten son, that whosoever believed in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Just look at about two people around you and say, I thank God for you. Did I tell you all your white friends are not all of them are colonizers, but you ought to thank God for people who don't have the same natural hue, the same natural tan, and the same natural body build that you, but they have been a true friend in your life. My brothers and sisters, when you needed some help, when you needed a hand, when you lost hope, it wasn't always Mookie and Aisha who came to the rescue, but you gotta thank God for Jake and Emily and Kaylin and Molly who stood up on your behalf, who stepped in for you, either spoke up and whisper a prayer on your behalf. You got to thank God for your friend. Thank God for people who love you in spite of your flaws, in spite of your failure, in spite of your foul places. Thank God for friends who don't give up on you, and friends who can appreciate the differences that confirm that you are all not alike, that we all cry, that we all worry, we all fear, we all have a problem, we all have habits, we all have flaws, we all get moody, we all get temporal and often have a bad attitude. Thank God for friends who love you even though that there are areas that we are still broken, that we are still struggling in areas where we have made the mark, but still love you anyhow. That still protect us, that still pray for us, that have been there through some basic moments of I've learned anything in 2023 thus far. I've learned that hard time will always reveal your true friends. Thank God for true friends. We have friends, but before I go any further, I want you to understand that there will become enemies, which I like to call them frenemies. Let the church say frenemies. And if you don't understand what I'm trying to say, come here, OJ, and let me tell these people what I'm talking about. They call them backstabbers. They smile in your face all the time. They just want to take your place, backstabbing. Y'all act like y'all don't know that song, but I'm going to preach it anyhow. But enemies are the people who can't stand you, but they like being close to you. Preach, Dr. Kelly. And frenemies are the folks who are always on your page on social media, but never like your pictures. Preach it like I feel it. They hate your skill, but they always show up at your game, in your life. You got friends who you got frenemies. And whatever you want to believe this or not, I need to remind you in 2023 that all of us some enemies. Look at your neighbor and say, I got some enemies. You got some enemies. All God's children got some enemies. Yes, all of you have some enemies, whether you like it or not. And I don't care how good you are, or if somebody doesn't like you. I don't care how cute or handsome you are. Somebody ain't looking at you. I don't care how gifted or how anointed you may be, but there is somebody who ain't just feeling you. I don't care how well you do, what you do. There is somebody who's saying that ain't all you got. I don't care how well you look at your outfit. There is somebody who is saying that outfit is too tight, when in fact they wish they had the curves and the chest and the hips and the heart to wear what they can wear. I got to hurry along, St. James, but in this familiar song, Psalm 23 verse 5, in this particular text, it is clear that David is at a point and place in his life where he's dealing with some enemies. And it seems like all eyes are on him. And it's all because of the favor that is upon his life. And as we continue to move through 2023, the first lesson of only two today, St. James, that I want to share with you is number one, there will be some friction attached to your favor. Just look at somebody and say, there's some friction that's attached to your favor. Come on. Come on, look at somebody. Y'all ain't look at nobody yet. Come on, look at somebody and say, some friction are attached to your favor. Can I tell you, St. James, that favor will get you in trouble. It will cause you to be disliked. Yes, you can't have favor with some friction, without some resistance. David is the brother we're talking about in this text. In verse 5 of Psalm 23, it is clear that he has some enemies. It is clear because in this verse, he said that God prepared a table right in the presence of your enemies. Can I tell somebody that favor will get you in trouble? Point at your neighbor and say that favor will get you in trouble. Come on, point at your neighbor and say favor will get you in trouble. It will get you in trouble, but while they are hating, in verse 5, it said that he prepared a table. And I like the way the scholar Eugene Peterson says it. He said, God served me a 6-course meal dinner in front of my enemies. But notice, beloved, that this verse does not say that he finished it. It doesn't say that he completes it, but the text said he's preparing. And while he's preparing, your enemy just have to look and watch. Please, God, the killer. But check this out. They are hating on you for what God is doing in your life right now. But what they don't realize is that he's just getting started. Who am I talking to? I wish I knew who this sermon is for today, because I think this sermon is for the people who have people hating on you for what you have now, for where you are now, and for who you are now. But they don't know this. You haven't scratched the surface yet, because if God be for me, who can be against me? They're hating on you, and you just didn't start it, baby. If you are hating on you for what God is doing right now, you ain't seen nothing yet that my eyes have not seen, ear have not heard, nor have the answer in the heart of men. My brothers and sisters, if you're hating on me right now, you ain't seen nothing yet. Look at somebody and say, you ain't seen nothing yet. What are they going to do? But I've got to ask this question. What are they going to do when God really gives you what you've been praying for, and what you've been fasting for, and what you've been believing for? If you know anything about David, you know that David had his fair share of enemies. And we have a little Bible. Can we have just a little Bible study this morning in 1 Samuel chapter 16? When Samuel came to his father's house looking for a new king, his own father, Jesse, he counted him out and said, you don't want him. He's not the one. He was young. He was inexperienced. He's unknown, unpopular. But God said he's the one because he has a good heart. I wish I could just stay right there just for a little while. I will take heart over steel any day. I challenge everybody under the sound of my voice today. Don't you just find people who have a desire. I need you to sign people up for the kingdom who have a good heart. They may not be the most skilled, but make sure they have a good heart. They may not be able to quote the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, but make sure they have a good heart. They may not have been to church as long as you've been in church for years and still get upset when somebody sit on your favorite pew that don't even belong to you. They may not have tenure, but they sure enough have a good heart. Because the Bible says that men and women look on the outer appearance, but God looks at the heart. David had some haters. In chapter 17 of 1 Samuel, he says the deal. He had to deal with the hatred in Goliath, who called him a boy. And if you want to make a black man angry, especially in 2023, call a brother who's been kissed by the sun. If you want to bring out the thug that's hidden on the side of them, who will forget titles and degrees and certifications and tickets, I want you to call him a boy, and he will show you what he's working with. Goliath hated David, called him a boy, and challenged him to a fight. David has some haters. If you travel to 2 Samuel chapter 21, David has some new giants who were on the same bloodline as Goliath. Boy, I wish I had time to just deal with that right there. But when I need you to know today is that this Goliath wasn't the only giant that David had to deal with. No, big dude has some cousin that kept showing up. What are you trying to say, Pastor? I'm so glad to ask. All I'm trying to say is this. Don't be fooled. There are more than one giant in your life. comfortable because the lion has some cousin who are waiting just for you. Do I have a witness in the field? But if you know the story of this journey of David, then you already know that Saul hated him as well. Read 1 Samuel 18, because there you will discover that Saul wanted to kill him. All because one day he heard the voice of St. James' praise team saying, Saul killed his 1,000 and David killed his 10,000. David had some haters. Haters, beloved, are people who hate you because everybody else loves you. This is the crazy thing. They've been hating on you, but you ain't even think about them. Can I tell you, St. James, the haters are like crickets. They make a loud noise. You can't even hear them, but you can't see them. And when you walk past them, all of a sudden, they get quiet. Dr. Killer, let me say it again like this. Haters are like crickets. They make a lot of noise. You can hear them, but you can't see them. And when you walk past them, all of a sudden, they get quiet. If you like me sometime, I wish I could have one-on-one conversation with every one of my haters. Just inform them that they have to the same God and the same blessing that God has given me. I feel glory creeping on me here. Can I teach you today that this favor that you and I have should not be the reason of more hatred? Should not make you hate me. It should make you want to hear me. There are some people who are hating on you, but they never heard from you. They heard they heard what people say about you. But if you want to know something about me, don't ask my neighbor. Come talk to me. I will tell you what you need to know. Is there anybody in here who ain't scared in 2023? Talk about me as much as you please. The more you talk, my history. How am I talking to? Who am I talking to? I don't believe I'm alone when I say this, but there are people who are hating, but they have never heard your whole story. But I dare you to talk to your neighbor and say, my life hasn't always been good. My situation has not always been on the up. But when all, when I turn around and I think about the blessings of God, from blessing me over and over again. All of this is favor. Had some friction. I've been hurt. I've been broke. I've been sick. I've been let down. I've been disappointed. I've been disrespected. I've been disrejected. I've been misunderstood. I've been fired. I've been in a rough relationship. I had to cry. Lost some sleep. I lost some friend. I have some people I love. So the next time you want to hate on me, how I'm living, look at me smile right now. Look at me rejoice right now. Because I told the story has not been told. I would have fainted unless I lived to believe and see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Look at your neighbor and say, come on up. Because you had some bad days and some good days and some weary days, some sleepless nights. All but when I turn around and think things over, all of my good days outweigh my bad days, so I won't complain. Is there anybody who needs to look at somebody and say, my God will give me grace? I'm still here. I read something last week that says a tiger never lose sleep over the opinions of a sheep. You will get that when you get home. Because what people don't realize that this God have no favoritism. So that means the same God who favored me is the same God who favors you. Favor has its share of friction, not brothers and sisters. But finally, and I'm going to take my seat. Finally, point number two, you should know that favor also has its shares of fortune. Look at your neighbor and say, favor also has its share of fortune. Come on, some of y'all ain't looking at nobody yet. Favor has its share of fortune. Watch what David writes. He said that he prepares a table before me, right in the presence of my enemies. In other words, David is saying he is setting me up right now in front of the people who doubted me. Preach, Dr. Kennedy. He's doubling up right now in front of the people who've been talking about me, who is setting me right in front of the people who counted me out. He's setting me up right in front of the people who said I couldn't make it and I was worthless. David said he prepared a table. And I'm almost done, but can I make a confession? I've never been that good at setting a table. I know how to eat, but I don't know how to set a table. I can make a bed up. I can clean a house. I can mix up a pack of instant oatmeal and put it in a bowl as good as my mama can. But I'm not great at setting a table. Because there are certain ways that you got to place a fork. There are certain places you got to place spoon. There are certain places you got to put glass. There's certain ways that you got to fold and set the napkin. And I'm sorry, my brothers and sisters, those of you who are in hospitality, I ain't got time for all that. But can I tell you that the same way that your enemies are watching you, watching your table, as God is right now preparing and adding more stuff to your table, something that is not there yet. And I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that God is still adding to my table. It's not more because that I've been good. It's not because I've been that faithful. It's not because I deserve it. It's not because he owes me everything. But he keeps on adding to my table to give me a testimony that can't nobody do me like Jesus. He keeps adding to my table to prove that he's in love with the backsliders. He keeps adding to my table to prove that his grace is sufficient. Good morning, St. James. And may the Lord God bless you real good. He keeps adding to the table to prove that he's willing to look past your faults and seize your knees. And my prayer to God is that whatever you're doing in this season, please don't do it without me. Whatever you're doing in this season, keep my haters alive. Don't let them die. Keep them alive. The folks who said I wouldn't make it, keep them alive. The folks who walked away from me, keep them alive. The folks who talk about me, I want you to keep them alive. The folks who wish bad things on me, I want you to keep them alive. Because when you keep them alive, I want David to say, I prepare a table before you in the presence of my enemy, my beloved. He's always watching.
watching you, but never say that you are welcome to have a seat. Can I say it again? You might got some enemies who are watching you, but when you at your reserve table, only thing they can do is watch you, but they can't have a seat. They're not talking in here. They can't have a seat at your table. So as long as my enemies stay alive, I want to sit at the table where the feast of the Lord is going on. So good morning, St. James, and may the Lord come bless you real good. But is there anybody up in here that's got a made up mind? For God I live and for God I'll die. I came to tell St. James, don't allow the plotting of the enemies to cause you to become bitter. Don't become bitter. Just get busier. I don't know about you, but my haters are my motivators. My haters make me sing loud. My haters make me pray longer. My haters make me laugh louder. My haters make me preach more. My haters will make me serve better. My haters will make me work smarter. And all things will work together for the good of them who love God and who are called according to his purpose. My brothers and sisters, in this season, all eyes on me. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadows of death, I shall fear no evil. Do I have a witness that can jump on your feet, put your hands together, and say, all eyes on me, because no weapon from the against me shall prosper. All eyes on me, because they hung it high, stretched them wide, hung his head, and for me he died. But that's not how the story ends. But 3 days later, he rose with all power in his hand. All eyes on me, say yes.
Look at somebody and say, all eyes on me.
Hallelujah!
All eyes will be on you.
Hallelujah! Thank you, God.
and your testimony be, it was good for me that I have been afflicted. Because in my dark moments, in my troubling moments, in my depressing moments, that's when God began to deal with you. Because sometimes dark seasons doesn't mean that you isolate yourself in the world, but dark season means that you're preparing yourself for a coming out show that you will walk into the marvelous light.
Amen.
All eyes on me. You want to know why they're hating on you? Because all eyes are on me. Because favor ain't fast. I don't know about nobody else. I want to walk in God's favor. I want to sing in God's favor. I want to preach in God's favor. I want to serve in God's favor. So don't get weary in well doing. Because in due season, you'll faint. You'll reap if you faint not. Can I tell you why those black activists and scholars were able to do what they were able to do? It's because they had a moment with the Lord. That sometimes the enemies don't need to know your strategies.
Amen.
They just want to see you from afar to see what you're going to do next. So I came to challenge someone today. Stop walking around here with your head held down. Lift up your head. Stick your chest out. And walk into your divine purpose in the Lord. You are black and beautiful. You're black and handsome. You are smart and intelligent. You are fearfully and wonderfully made in the image of God. And don't allow anybody to tear you from that moment of your life. Will you do that? Can you lay hands on yourself? And say, self, all eyes on me. So many times that you have put yourself on the back burner. But I declare that 2023 is 20 me. Did you hear what I said? 2023 is 20 me.
Hallelujah.
And if you don't like it, deal with it. I don't care. Because I want God to pour His Spirit in me. I want God to talk with me. I want God to pour His blessing as a launch on me. The reason why some of us can't receive the blessings or the anointing is because we got too much stuff that's in the way of you that you got to sort out. So in 2023, do you, let's all stand. There may be someone who may not know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Here's an opportunity for you to know Jesus. If that's you, I want you to come. Second invitation for those persons. church home, a new church family, I offer you St. James A. Luke Church. The Lord has sent me here season of my life to pastor you. I love to be your pastor. I love us to be your church family. Yes, you. Last invitation for those persons who just need to talk to you, Lord, and say, God, help me to discover my purpose in 2023. Help me to enjoy me in 2023. That's you. The altar's available for you. Pray to see you leading us.
Oh, my
brother. The church allow me.
Desperately need.
God bless our school boards, God, in the name of Jesus. Bless the House of Representatives, God, in the name of Jesus. Bless our President, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, bless all our preachers, civic leaders, God. Oh, God, police force, God, we first responders, God, we lift them up in prayer, God. I pray for your health. Pray for your children. Pray for your wife. Pray for your husband, God, in the name of Jesus. Do it now, God. Do it now, God. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you believe that, lift your hands and just say, God, thank you. Say, God, thank you. Say, God, thank you. I receive it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, put your hands together and feel that God is working out of your life. Amen. 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 Just look at somebody and say, all eyes are on me.
All eyes are on me.
Amen. Amen. At this time, my brothers and sisters, we're going to receive our offering at this moment. Amen. We know that the Lord loves a cheerful giver. If you give unto the Lord will give back unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over that you may not have room enough to receive. But God said in His Word that He can and will open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing that you may not have room enough to receive. You can't beat God's giving. No matter how hard you try. And so, my beloved brothers and sisters, you have a few ways that you can be a blessing into the life and ministry of St. James Avery Church. If you have Givelify, search for St. James Avery Church, Columbia, and you'll be able to give through our Givelify apparatus. Or if you have your camera phone device, you may point your phone to the QR code and it will directly send you to the Givelify apparatus of St. James Avery Church. Those of you who are watching online, God bless you. And if you would like to be a blessing to our ministry on today, you may mail your gifts to the P.O. Box 5594 Columbia, South Carolina 29250. Amen. And for those of you who are in the worship experience, we will give in-house on this day. Amen. We want you to know that cash and check is still accessible. Amen. In the house of God. If you're prepared to give, whether it's envelope or electronic, my brothers and sisters, can you lift it up as a point of contact? Amen. Whether it's your envelope or your technological advice. Amen. Amen. I said all of that wrong, but y'all know what I was talking about. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Repeat these words. Say with a loud voice. Say, God,
God,
I thank you
that I have it
to give. Thank you for allowing me to be a blessing to St. James Church. Now, God, multiply it, sanctify it, use it for your glory and for your honor. This I ask in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Those of you, my brothers and sisters, who are given by envelope, we will ask you to pass those gifts to the center aisle. Amen. Amen. Pass those gifts to the center aisle. And our ushers will come, amen, as we receive these gifts. Amen. Amen. And while our ushers are coming, I'm going to ask, amen, our sound tech person will go ahead and play the announcements, amen, at this time while you're receiving these gifts. Amen. Praise God. Come on, put your hands together and bless God's name. Amen. Come on, put your hands together for the right space. Amen. Thank you so much. I want to just say, my brothers and sisters, we give God praise and we give God honor for God just continuing to shine his grace upon us. Amen.
Amen.
And we pray that you have enjoyed this old school Sunday on this day. Amen. Amen. Come on, put your hand together for praise to you. Amen. And to our musician. Amen. Our whole purpose of doing this is to always remind ourselves of where we came from. Amen. I know that we got all these new artists or whatever the case may be, but they ain't nothing like the foot stomping, hand clapping, church mothers and church fathers song that got them through. Amen. Y'all can have all that other stuff. Give me Mississippi Mass Choir and Shirley Caesar and all of those persons. Amen. Amen. Because I know when I'm down, I go to those songs to help me and lift me up. Amen. And since we are in our heritage months, amen, it is very fitting, amen, that we take an old school, amen, throughout the whole month, amen. So we give God praise and we give God honor, amen. Also, I want to acknowledge Sister Jeanette Haskell. If you please stand, amen. We had our labor retreat, amen, this past weekend, amen. And Sister Jeanette Haskell is our lay president here at St. James Avery Church. And I want you to know that she represented well. Amen. 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 And I have the privilege of doing a few of the workshops, amen, that Sister Jeanette Haskell was able to witness, amen. I was sharing in that particular workshop talking about walking into your purpose, amen. Live it, walk it, and talk it, amen. And so if you don't know right now, my brothers and sisters, your purpose, it is okay. You can still discern and define your purpose in life, amen. Amen. If you want that presentation, just come holler at your preacher. Amen. I'll make sure that you get that information. Amen. Also, we want to ask that you will continue to pray for one of our churches in the Newberry District. Amen. One of our churches, our roof is leaking very badly. Amen. And so we will, amen, amen, we will as a church send a donation to help that church, amen, a little small seed gift to help that church in the efforts of repairing that particular leakage in that particular roof. Amen. We had a special service at Brown Chapel on last night. Amen. And so we want to be a blessing to that particular church. Amen. I was able to sow a seed. Amen. But I want the church to sow a seed as well. Amen. We praise God and we thank God. Also, on this Saturday at 8:30 in the morning, amen, we will have our Founders Day, a worship experience at Whitehall Amy Church in Jenkinsville. Amen, amen. And I have registered all stewards and trustees for that particular training. Amen. And we ask brothers and sisters, if you can, will be present for that Founders Day worship experience and steward and trustee training at Whitehall Amy Church in Jenkinsville. Amen. Amen. Last but certainly not least, amen, I want to acknowledge a very special guest, amen, in the house who is the Columbia branch, amen, president of the NAACP. Amen. 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 Sister Olivia Glover. Amen. Amen. Sister, can we come and just keep us in our own special way? Amen. Come on, put your hands together. Amen. This is the NAACP. President Branch of Columbia, South Carolina. Thank you for sharing with us.
You know, you have to always tell the truth when it's out to me. So this is the time that I am, and I really need the lift. So I appreciate it. I'm crying the same to you on that old time. It's what it takes. My family, I am Olivia Glover, as mentioned, and I'm the president of the Columbia Branch NAACP. We say NAACP, can you say it after me?
NAACP.
No more NAA, you hear me? Alright, I tell you all, we're trying to rebrand, and we're trying to use it as a market tool. So we won't be figured out as being the NAAC. What is that football thing?
NCAA.
Well, NCAA. So that's what we're trying to do to rebrand, and that's why the change is being made. But I want to encourage those of you that are members, and you need to renew y'all. We need you more now than ever. Our babies are being destroyed. But if you're not talking, and to be truthful of Dr. Kenny, the church is where the NAACP started. Amen. We have to take it back there. We can't do it without you. You see, when you're in the church, you need to be telling that baby right there what the NAACP is all about. Because if not, our history will die, and we don't need that to happen. We need history to repeat itself so these youths can understand from, Pastor said it earlier, from where she came. Okay? So this is my plea to anybody and everybody that I have the opportunity to get up and say anything about. Now, that's one hat, Doctor. I'm going to put the other hat on. I'm the president for the NAACP, but I'm also president of the Funds Incorporated, which is the organization that puts on the annual statewide Black History Parade and Festival. We have been doing it 18 years. And it's time for y'all to show up. We show up.
That's right.
Y'all know that, right? Yeah. Okay, they show up. But I need you to come. It's right down the street, 5 months. Bring your youth. It's an educational event. What we do, everybody that participates in it has to depict someone of African American history. When she comes to a table, she'll be able to walk away with something about the size as they're supposed to be, or at least have heard some type of history. So they'll be able to go back and tell their friends, I met Olivia Glover. And Olivia Glover was one of the first African Americans to integrate the schools for the state of South Carolina. That's the truth. Yeah. Okay? So, the best thing is, for the state of South Carolina, y'all, not the one, see, Columbia was a little behind. Y'all wouldn't finish until 77. That was in 1963 when I actually attempted to do that. It was in 1960. We actually did it in 1963. Charleston was the catalyst. See the history you learned? So, with that being said, you need to take that and tell somebody. I met Ophie. You know, she's a normal person.
Yeah.
She likes to talk sometimes, but she's a normal person. So my plea to you is to please encourage those. It's a typical parade and festival held in Martin Luther King Park. We come down Harvard Street. The cars, the horses, the kids will be able to ride the bus. You know, et cetera. But you will walk away with some education. Again, I thank you, Pastor, for this opportunity, and I look forward to those of you renewing your membership, because I think this was a church that was full of NAACP members. This is time for you to renew if you haven't, and if you need some assistance, we do have a new office. It's at 1615 Pickens Street. First time the branch has had an office in many years, and under my coverage, we have been able to do so. So I thank you, and if you need to talk to me after, I'll be here for a minute. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. I need to we have any questions, comment, concern, you can see her after worship. Sister Beverly Brooks?
We have flyers. The parade is Saturday, February the 25th. And the flyers will be out on the table out here. And I also have some applications for NAACP. And I'd like to thank Sister Pearson, David, and Linda. They joined the NAACP. They've been members for quite a while. I've been trying to get Pastor He's coming. He's coming. But I've always tried to encourage us to join NAACP because that's where it started from, in the church. And Ovita and Gail, this is her sister. Dr. Benjamin Glover was president at Allen University. That's their father. He was an AME minister. So, I mean, and he was involved with NAACP. So there's a lot of memory, a lot of history in NAACP with the AME. So we must support. We've got to support. And Debo is a member. She keep pulling my skirt. So she's a member. But anyway, we'll have flyers out here on the table if anyone's interested. Thank you.
At this time, my brothers and sisters, as we now shift into our Holy Communion service, I want you to know that this is not St. James's table. This is not Reverend Kinley's table. But this is the Lord's table. And he invites each and every last one of you, my brothers and sisters, to partake at this Lord's table. Today's menu, my brothers and sisters, is not a menu of your choice. But it's a menu that says bread and wine. The wafer that represents the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that was broken for you, we will eat it in a few minutes. Amen. The welches, amen, juice that we have prepared for you represent the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that was shed on Calvary's cross for you and for me. And so we ask that you will participate, amen, and stay with us as we go into this Holy Communion service, amen. As our praise team and musicians prepare ourselves now, amen, for the Lord's Supper, we will now gather our minds and our spirits to partake in the Lord's Supper.
Liberty and have a
say?
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, with whom great mercy and promises forgiveness of our sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto you, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver us from all of our sins, confirm and strengthen us in the goodness, and bring us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Church say,
Amen. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires are known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our heart by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthy ministry your holy name through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Church say,
Amen. It is with very deep right that our abundance, that they, the duty that we shall at all times and in all places give thanks unto you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we, loud and mighty, your holy name, evermore, praising and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth is full of your glory. Glory be to you, Lord.
Church say, presume to come to your table, merciful Lord, trusting your own righteousness. But in your manifold and great mercy, we are not worthy so much to gather crumbs from under your table. But you are the same Lord, so prompt us always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, a soul to eat of the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, and our sinful souls and bodies may be cleansed by his death and washed through his blood. And that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. And the church say, sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole wide world. And in an institution, in this holy gospel, command us to continue perpetual memory of that his most precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we love and humbly beseech you and grant that we receive in these your creatures of bread and wine according to your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Holy institution, remembrance of his death and his passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who on the same night that he was betrayed and kissed by Judas, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat this. This is my body that was broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he gave thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it. For this is the blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sin. Do this as often as you shall drink it in remembrance of me. In the church of God, say, Amen.
Amen.
At this time, my brothers and sisters, we're going to be distributing the elements on this day. We ask that once you receive the elements, that you will hold them, and we will share together collectively as a family. Amen? Amen. As we're doing this, we're going to ask that our musicians, amen, to begin to play our communion hymn at this appropriate time as we get in the mindset of communion.
Thank you.
let us all stand over the house. We ask, brothers and sisters, that you return back the first layer. Amen. That expose the wafer, which represent the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let's give it up. This is the blessed broken body that was broken for you and for me, my brothers and sisters. Let's break it together and let's eat together. We ask that you pull back the second layer, which exposes the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. What can wash away our sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make us whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. It reaches to the highest mountain, flows to the lowest valley. It will never, shall never, lose its power. Let's lift it up. Let's toast it to God, and let's drink together. Amen. Remain standing, my brothers and sisters. Let's recite the Lord's Prayer in unison. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. And sisters, after they ate together, after they drank together, they departed into the Mount of Olives, and they began to fellowship with one another, and they began to sing the songs of Zion. Just look at somebody around you, my brothers and sisters, and say, the peace of God be with you. Upon you, be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light of his kind and give you. his peace and his shalom through Jesus Christ our Lord, we shall say like this.
Yes, yes, yes. Oh, she can pick up a little ashy bit. Yeah.
The Spirit has poured.
Yeah.